need a title for these. Maybe call it Orion Rant. Or make a compound word out of that. Call it a riant. No, that's stupid. Call it a video idea. A vidia. No, that's equally stupid. Waffling. Take one. I've got an upstep stomach today. An upstep? Upstep, baby. I've got an upset stomach today. Yesterday I had some Mr. Potato Head salad for lunch. Took me forever to chew down the red nose and blue sneakers. I really should eat more salad. All the vegetables I had on the weekend were a smattering of onions on my quarter pounder. Smatter for you, huh? That's a nice stereotype. Last week, I went grocery shopping. Bought me a box of toaster waffles and toaster pancakes so that I may settle the long, straining quandary of our generation. Which is better, toaster waffles or toaster pancakes? For round one, I loaded the toaster up with two waffles while they were toasting up. I looked in the fridge for some margarine to melt on top. Got it? Yum. Looking for some syrup? No dice. Bought toaster waffles and had no syrup waiting for it. I must be a total asshole. I can't just put margarine alone on top of it. That would be disgusting. I pull the toaster trigger and prematurely reemerge my waffles. I look in the fridge for some syrup substitute. What do I have? I have salad dressings, blue cheese, Russian, golden Italian, three cheese ranch, soy sauce, none of which are appropriate on a waffle. Yeah, you can put soy sauce on a salad. Shut up! I have some habanero death sauce that my wife bought for me at a craft show just to see if my intestines could take it. Just to see if my gutty works could withstand the fiery capabilities. I could and I did. My asshole hasn't been that sore since I sang in the Port McNichol choir. What?
What?
The pee was uncomfortable, especially after the choir practice. Eow. The closest substitute I had to maple syrup was a half full jar of no-name strawberry jam. Mm. I have no brand name loyalty. At all. As Jim Reed once said, if you want loyalty, buy a dog. I put my prematurely lifted waffles onto a plate, scooped out some margarine, scooped out some jam, and consumed that mediocre pile of lackluster with all the enthusiasm of a black-eyed trophy wife told that she can't come along on the impromptu trip to Hawaii. The next morning, I have off work, but my wife doesn't. My itinerary for the day is of brevity and levity, as I plan on watching the short-lived, brilliantly executed Tim and Eric's Tom Goes to the Mayor. Drop wife off out of work, across the street to a department store to get maple syrup only. Couldn't find it, but I did find orange juice with lots of pulp. A package of breakfast sausages and a deluxe knockoff brand pizza for $3. I figure since there is no syrup, I'll grab some corn syrup and I'll pretend. But instead of visiting one of the 30 other locations I could, within blocks, like 30 other places I could buy groceries. But I don't do that because, no, I have sausages, orange juice, and a pizza. I should live fat and stuffed for at least another week. So I find the corn syrup and right there next to it, bang, some maple syrup. Up to the counter I go, where a smiling Marianne, that's what it said on her name tag, it might not be her name, it might be her alias. Marianne rang up my bounty. She told me that my breakfast sausages looked very good for breakfast. And I agreed with her. They should be good for breakfast. After all, they are breakfast sausages.
Sausages. Sausages, ma'am. Sausages. Sausages, ma'am.
She said that my pizza did not look good for breakfast. She's like, that wouldn't be. I know lots of people that eat pizza and drink Coke for breakfast. I said, I believe you, Marianne. Do you want to go have some breakfast sausages with me? She said, no, I can't. I have to stay here at the department store. Like, you're lost. Sugar tits.